All right, so in this video, we've got some radical with division, but you'll notice that there's nothing, in, you know, no radical in the numerator that will simplify with the radical in the denominator. So there's two ways we could go about this. We could simplify the square root of 8, and, you know, and then we'd still be stuck. Or we can go ahead and do this trick that I'm about to show you. This is called rationalizing the denominator. All right. Rationalize the denominator. So because we have a square root in the denominator, we have to force it to become, you know, a non-square root or a rational number. Now, to do this, what we're going to do is we're going to multiply by 1, but it's a very special 1, right? So we've got a square root of 8 in the denominator. I'm going to multiply top and bottom by the square root of 8. Now, this is just a 1, but what this is going to do is it's going to force the denominator to become a rational number, all right? So square root of 8 times the square root of 8, that is the square root of 64, which just becomes 8. So in the denominator, we have an 8. And then in the numerator, we just have 4 times the square root of 8, which is 4 root 8, all right? We can simplify that. Let's see, square root of 8. Square root of 8 is, you know, a 2 and a 4, which is a 2 and a 2. So we've got two pairs of 2s. So we've got a 4 times, those 2s will come out as a 2. And then you still have a 2 left over on the inside. Great. Well, 4 times 2 is 8, and then that 8 can cancel with that 8. So you cancel all that, and that just leaves you with the square root of 2. All right. Let's do another example here. We've got 10 root 15 over 3 root 90. Now, what you want to try first is seeing if the, you know, the numerator will simplify with the denominator in any way, and they will in this case. 15 and 90, let's simplify that. 15 divided by 90, all right, and then we'll convert that to a fraction. So we got math, and then convert that to a fraction. That gives us 1 over 6, okay? So this is going to give us 10 root 1, or just 10, over 3 root 6. All right. Now, to get rid of that square root in the denominator, we're going to multiply top and bottom by the square root of 6. All right. Let's see. That's going to give us a 10 root 6 in the numerator. In the bottom, let's see, root 6 times root 6 is root 36, and that simplifies down to just 6. So we have 3 times 6. All right. Let's see, our final step here, we've got 10 root 6 over 18. The 10 and the 18, you can divide them both by 2. So that's going to give us a 5 up top and a 9 in the bottom. Now you always want to check and see if the square root of 6 will simplify. But that's just, you know, a 2 and a 3, so it will not. All right. So that will be our final answer. Okay. Last example here. 7 and 14, you can divide those both by 7. So that leaves you a 6 on top. And this will be a square root of 2x on the bottom. All right. This is just an x, not an x to the, you know, third or fourth or anything. So you can't simplify that at all. So we're going to multiply top and bottom by the square root of 2x. On the bottom, it gives you the square root of 4x squared, which will simplify just to 2x. All right. So you wind up with a 2x on the bottom. And on the top, you get 6 root 2x. Now the numerator will simplify with the denominator. You can just divide them both by 2. So that'll be a 3 root 2x on top and just an x on the bottom. Now that's this whole process, remember, is called rationalizing the denominator. So whatever the denominator was, here it was a root 6, you just multiply top and bottom by that. Here it was a root 2x, we just multiply top and bottom by root 2x.